So, hello everybody, this is Deepak. I'm the faculty for Ethics and Public Administration at Officers AIS Academy. And today we have with us Ms. Divya Mishra, who has secured All India rank 28 this year in the Civil Services Examination. And what is very special is she is also the highest scorer in the General Studies paper with a score of around 455. And she is also the highest scorer in the ethics paper as well. And today through this session, let us speak to her regarding her strategy for the General Studies paper. And let's see what really makes so much of a difference, right? So first of all, Divya, congratulations and thank you for joining us today.
Thank you so much, sir. And it's always a privilege. And I always love to talk about with the fellow aspirants. So it's always a nice experience.
Thank you. Thank you, Divya. So first of all, there are many students, many aspirants whom I personally know who consistently clear the preliminary examination, but the main examination is always a washout for some people. So what is really that secret ingredient that makes anybody do well in the main examination?
So the study is very integrated and holistic in nature. What I have seen in my three attempts is that in all three attempts, I have written the main exam as well as the prelims. So my understanding is examination in the prelims itself is going more towards being analytical and application oriented. If you read the ethics, the prelims paper, of 2020, you will realize there are so many questions which are not just about facts. If one has prepared thoroughly for the mains, each topic and the topic in its wholesomeness, then through that understanding and maybe that wisdom, we can approach the prelims paper. So it's the other way around, not from prelims to mains to interview. It's like mains is the mainstay of the exam that will inform our opinion in the interview stage and will also help us in eliminating the options with even less facts at the prelims stage.
Okay, okay. So comparing your previous attempt with this one, so before the main examination, when we had some discussions, you mentioned that, your score in the philosophy paper in your previous attempt was very high. And this time after the mark sheet is out, you found out that your optional paper score has come down a little bit, but your GS has, taken you to altogether to a different level, right? So what do you think was really the difference that, the difference that you had this time? What do you think, where did it come from?
Well, to be very honest, the amount of hard work that I have put in my optional and all the GS paper was actually the same.
Okay.
So this means that there is a little degree of unpredictability also. And as an aspirant, we should always embrace that. We do not know what will happen. So what we can do is give our best for all the four GS paper, essay paper, and the interview stage and the optional. And then let us see how competition fares, what will happen. What has been different in GS this year especially is that I have focused on the GS, that is true. And I have been very practice-oriented, because what has happened that after a certain amount of time, a knowledge base does build up. We know the facts, we know the topics, be it in disaster management, security, women, children, everything we know. Problem is we do not know how to present it and in a stipulated manner. And also in the orientation of question has to be right also. What not to do, what to do, and populating with examples also. For instance, in ethics this year, what I think I have done is, especially in those reflective questions that we see towards the end of the part A, these are quotations and we have to interpret. So we do not know, they're very philosophical in nature. So what we do in such question is taking them out of their abstractness and filling them with concrete examples where that abstractness can be justified.
Okay, okay. And picking on what you've mentioned about presentation of facts and data and examples. So did you have a separate sheet for all the data facts which you had prepared beforehand and it came in handy while you were writing the exam?
No, sir, I did not have that much luxury of time, but
okay.
I will suggest with sincerity to the aspirants that it is always a good thing that you maintain the repository of all the relevant facts, keep on updating them. And more important than that part is, you know, utilizing those facts in your answer writing. Otherwise, there will be just, you know, a lot bunch of facts with you burdening you mentally and you're not able to utilize them. It will create an additional pressure. So both the things which I have not done in this manner, but if I were to repeat that time this year, I would do it like this.
Okay, okay. And overall, Divya, if you're looking at the main examination, if you're looking at content and if you're looking at presentation, so, you know, how much, in what ratio would you give either of these things the respective importance?
I have always thought that content is very important because, you know, questions are very analytical in nature, be it GS1, right. GS4. So it can go in really any direction. Content brings the ability to judge that which part of syllabus it belongs to, how it is to be answered. So content cannot, the quality of it cannot be compromised. It should be from relevant sources and we should be thorough with it. So I will give around 70 to 80% dependent on the topic as well. This much
comes
to it. And rest will go to the presentation. For instance, in ethics paper this year, we had the questions about Socrates and what he has said about relative moral values and it is an illusion. Relative emotional values and it is an illusion, something like that. And then we have another question about emotional intelligence. So emotional intelligence question, we look in the ethics paper GS4. It was very straightforward from the syllabus. Need to be answered in that manner only. No need to do extra. But the other question about Socrates and his quote was very analytical. So the presentation and the content will vary when the questions vary.
Okay.
In ethics, I have not drawn any figure. I have not been into any of that because I did not feel any need to do that. But yet numbers are sound, which shows that the strategy needs to change based on the questions being asked.
Okay. Because I remember that we were having a discussion before the main examination and you wanted to know which pattern to follow. So when there is a question that involves comparison between two things, whether we need to go for a vertical comparison of the points or, you know, write it in a paragraph format. So you were very specific about the importance of presentation. So which is why I asked you.
Yes, sir. I am not able to recall the question. For example, in ethics this year, we have one question that, for instance, if there is this, that what is what? First question comes with what? And another second part is why? Or advantage or disadvantage? Then vertical presentation is good. But, you know, I changed the style after that because I realized that always going vertical is not fine because it becomes very factual and some of the analysis degree goes. So again, I will say diversifying is good. You know, don't stick to vertical or horizontal. Make it a salad bowl. Have a portfolio.
Okay. And so with respect to your studies over, have that different or how was your exam for, you know, for every topic, the study cell prepare so much content beforehand, and depending on the demand of the question, you modify it accordingly and present. So, did you have a similar strategy or how did you?
Yes, I was in knowing the in beginning of preparation. Later on, now. Prior to this year also, focus was largely on practicing what I had already written. Because, you know, the topics, they might appear so many, but I don't know what is a number to put, maybe more than 2,000, 3,000, maybe less than how many topics we have altogether. But what's more important is updating them and having a basic way of writing them. For instance, if a question is asked on, let's just say, earthquake in disaster management, then how are we going to introduce it? Are we going to say that India is prone to this, this much portion of India is prone to this earthquake, and these are the areas affected, these are the causes, these are the impacts? What are, what is the government doing for that? What is the legislative framework for that? And what some case studies, what others are doing, for example, how Japan is handling that. And then maybe talking about some inspirational quote, somebody has said that I am forgetting that. So there is some data also, if you spend something dollars on preparation, then these many dollars will be saved after the disaster. So these things. So I'm talking about earthquake, and it has all these data. So whenever a question comes, I will be addressing that. And if earthquake does not come, simply it comes that Hyogo frameworks and life framework, then also I might be picking some from the earthquake part also, and some from maybe tsunami. So it is like that, topic-wise comprehensiveness.
Okay, okay. And so one other concern that most aspirants preparing for the main examination have is, so they keep reading the editorials on a daily basis, and they do this for more than a year. Now they are sitting on way too much content, right? And most of the time this content is not organized. Sometimes they've just underlined, you know, in the newspaper directly, they have cutouts. So how have you gone about consolidating the knowledge that you have gotten from the editorial and converting it into something that is useful directly for the main examination?
So reading editorial is always a good strategy, but sometimes editorials are very politically charged and they are not that relevant to our purpose. So the utility point will come into picture and become clear when we practice it in our answer writing. For instance, one has read around 5 articles on the issue of women, on all the health, education, all the parameters. But if the question comes, for instance, in GS2, anything about women, how are we going to approach this answer? Am I going able to recall the theoretical arguments which were made in that editorial, or the data which was used in that editorial? So this utility will come when we solve the answers. There is no other way to it. And also when we, you know, start looking at the previous year UPSC question papers, we understand that what they are trying to, you know, see in the aspirant's mind, what is happening. So we also get picky in our data also. This has happened with me, that I used to spend maybe 4-5 hours reading the newspaper and coming out with so much of it, not able to revise at all. This has happened for a long time. But gradually with practice, I became very precise on what I want, what I do not want. So factor enrichment has gone to that level that even today I can recall many facts that I have prepared during the preparation. So it is only because it has happened over and over and over again. So sir, practice is key, sir.
So for you, ultimately, it goes down to, you know, what it is on your mind to what it is on paper. So you've exercised so much of, you know, this writing and taking tests.
The same thing is very important. But if we can't use it, there is no utility to all that data. It is just a burden on our this mental space.
Right. So, so if you're looking at your attempt this year, approximately how many full tests would you have written, Divya?
Sir, I would have written 50 in mains at least.
Fantastic. Okay.
And these 50 are the ones with sincerity, not the ones like we are writing and then submitting and we are not looking at the feedback. By 50, right. I mean completing the cycle, writing the test, submitting it, it got checked, listening to the feedback, incorporating it into the next. So these are the 50 full cycle ones.
Okay. And this is in addition to what you did the last time, right?
So last time I could not write many test papers. So my preparation, I was not completely prepared, let's just say in UPSC terms, for the exam at that point of time. There were some time issues. I was into some other academy program also. But this year I have dedicated a lot of time for GS. And so that has been rewarding for me.
Okay. So for all the beginners who are watching this, if there are just 5 things that you want to tell regarding the main examination preparation. So just 5 things that they constantly need to keep, you know, running into their mind. So what are those 5 things that you would want to give to any new aspirant?
Okay. First, I will say it's a long journey. It's not an exam. UPSC is a journey. At the end of it, being able to be a civil servant or not, it changes you. It evolves you. So after reading so much, you become a different person. So have that faith that it is going to be rewarding no matter what. And second is having faith in ourselves, because it's a long journey. So there are going to be setbacks, prelims, mains, interview. We don't know what will happen. Highly unpredictable exam. So many good people, really brilliant ones, are not able to clear. It is not because they were not that good. It is only because somewhere in some exam, in some paper, something got wrong. So that is why do not focus that I will do well in ethics and essay and maybe optional and I will be able to make it. It doesn't happen like that. Focus on every one of it. We do not know where we will be doing well and where competition will throw us out. We don't know. So this unpredictability is there. So be thorough. And then I will say have a faith in the expert advice, which is there. There is so much resource. So I intend to make this point that we do not just want content experts around us. We want mentorship. So whoever is mentor to anybody, so they should seek advice from them. And that interaction has to be there throughout, so that the misgivings and the confusion which arises, which is time to use, which not to use, it goes away. For instance, I myself has consulted you when about the ethics, what to do, what not to do. Now hindsight, it appears that yeah, it was one of the things that I was struggling with, but at that point, that one idea can make a lot of difference. So this advice is there. And finally, practice is very important. Reading is not going to help at any stage of this preparation, prelims, mains, or the personality test. So be always on the practice mode and reevaluate yourself. Where you are lacking, what is your rank, if there are All India exams being conducted by different institutions. And then seek advice from the mentors and assess yourself and have faith in yourself. It is just an exam and it can happen. You just have to be thorough and be patient.
Okay.
I was very long. I'm sorry on that.